Hello there everyone, Courtney here from How to Loom Your Dragon. Welcome to my tutorial for the Triple Strike from the How to Train Your Dragon show, Race to the Edge. This is going to be a smaller guy, so I refer to it as the baby version. I'm not sure if I'm going to be doing a large version or not. So you can check the description for the band count. This guy is probably like a medium difficulty. So he might be a little trickier than some of my other tutorials, but he's not too bad. So if you have some experience making the little guys on my channel, hopefully he won't be too difficult for you. Okay. You only need one loom. And so let's get started. All right. We're going to start with his lower jaw. Okay. So the closest color I had to match was just regular yellow, so I'm just going to be using regular yellow for that. Okay, so my loom is in the rectangular configuration, and I'm taking two bands at a time, and I'm going to go down the center 5 times. So now we're going to take 2 yellow bands at a time, going across to create our horizontals. Okay, so now I'm going to cap off the end by wrapping 1 band around, creating 4 loops on the peg. Alright, so now I'm going to take my hook, I'm going to dig under that cap band to find the top 2 diagonals, which are these 2, and we'll loop those first. We'll go all the way up this side. And we'll dig back down under that cap band again to grab these 2 diagonals. And we'll loop up this side. And then we'll go up the center. Stop at the this set here. Stop here because we're going to make an attach a tongue. Okay? So I'm going to be making a... Well, in some pictures he has a red tongue, in some it is a pink tongue. I'm just going to be using red, I think. Okay, so you take a red band, you're going to wrap it around your hook, creating 5 loops on the hook. 4 or 5. I like 5 better, it gives it a nice tight look. Take 2 bands onto your hook, and we're going to pull that cap band onto those 2 bands. So those 5 loops are now around that band. Reclaim the other end on your hook like so, so it looks like a little bow. Now we're going to take 2 more bands and we're going to pull those onto there. Okay. 2 more. And 2 more. Like so. Alright, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to, as I loop these 2, once I pull them up, I'm going to pull that tongue onto them and just finish looping that up so the tongue is now attached. Okay. Alright, so now I'm going to grab 3 bands of any color. Doesn't matter because we will be taking this off later. And I'm just going to tie slip knots. Okay, at 3 ends. So at the 3 ends. So I'm going through all the loops at the end and I'm just tying little slip knots so it stays together for now. And then I'm going to gently, from the bottom, use my hook to lift this off. You can also take it off from the top. Sometimes I like to do it from the bottom just so it doesn't get stretched out. Okay, so that is going to be his lower jaw. Okay, we're going to work on his head now. Okay, so just bear with me as we do this. I'm going to take my time just so everything is right. Okay, I'm going to use the burgundy for his main body color, including the head. That was the closest color I could find. It's kind of like a dark black purple, almost. I don't even know what the color is. I was trying to find out in the pictures, but I thought my burgundy bands looked closest. All right, so I'm taking 2 at a time. Gonna go down 6 times. Okay, now I'm gonna go down the side 2 at a time, up to there for now. Now let's do the other side. 2. Okay, what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna take some white bands for his teeth, okay? I'm gonna take one and I'm gonna wrap it around my hook, creating 5 loops. You can do it with 4 loops, but 5 loops give it a better look. Take 2 burgundy bands, and we're going to pull that white band onto the burgundy bands. Okay. After we have done that, we're going to put those loops around here and here. All right, we're going to do it again. So, white band wrapped around, creating 5 loops. 2 burgundies. Pull it on. Goes around there. Okay. Let's do it again. Okay, and we can also, you know, let's put teeth on these 2 as well. And then if we don't like them, we could always take them off. Just because on the pictures of him, he shows him having like 4 big teeth on each side at the top, so that's what we'll do here. Whoops. So make sure you don't, okay, there we go. You guys love it when I change my mind, don't you? Okay. Alright, okay. What I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna lift off this row of bands. So lift off those 2, let them rest, lift off those 2, let them rest, and lift off those 2, let them rest. We're gonna take our lower jaw, we're gonna hold it so the tongue is facing up. Okay? We're gonna go through the 4 yellow loops on the side here that are being held together by that orange loop. You can pull that orange band off. Wrap those 4 yellow loops around that peg and then replace those 2 resting bands back over them. Okay, let's do the middle set next. So going through the yellow loops, take off that tying band and wrap the yellow loops around the center set. And then we're gonna replace these guys back on. Okay, and it's okay if this kind of gets in the way, like as long as everything's attached in the correct order. The lower jaw's gonna kind of be a little bulky down there, and that's normal, so don't freak out about that. All right, so the last set. We'll wrap around these pegs, and then take those 2 laying bands and put them on. Okay, we can kind of just push the tongue down and everything. It doesn't matter where it gets pushed down. It could get pushed down over here. It doesn't matter. Okay. Alright. I'm going to take a burgundy, so body color, wrap it around your hook, creating 5 loops, and then take 3 burgundies, pull that cap band onto them. Okay, reclaim the loops on the other side, so it looks like a bow, and wrap the 6 loops of the bow around this bottom center peg here. Okay, like so. Okay, let's do his little nostrils now. So, I'm going to take 2 black bands. I'm going to wrap each one around my hook, creating 4 loops. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so 2 black bands wrapped around. Take 2 burgundy and pull each one on. Okay, and wrap the 2 ends around this peg and this peg over here. Then we're going to spread the nostrils apart. Spread the nostrils apart, okay, and you're going to grab 2 of the 4 of the burgundy bands between them and wrap them over this peg there, right in the middle. Okay, so it's attached there, and wrapped around that one. 1 nostril between each set. Okay. Alright, next, we're going to take 2 burgundies, and we're just going to put them across here, like so. Okay. Alright, next we're going to do the eyes. Okay, he's got red eyes. I'm going to use my shiny dual layer lava red ones. Okay, I'm going to take 1, wrap it around our hook, creating 4 loops. Then take a black for his pupil. Okay, wrap that around, creating 4 loops. And then another lava red. Okay. Alright, we're going to kind of just push that down on our hook, and we're going to put another eye right next to it. Okay, so same thing. Red, then black, then red again. Alright, take 2 of your burgundies and pull them on in order. So first we're pulling on the red, then the black, then the red, then this red, then this black, and then this red. Okay. Now, this is going to go around this peg and this peg. So the peg's right above the nostrils. Okay. Then I'm going to do the same thing I did with the nostrils. So we want to kind of, without lifting them because they'll fall right off, we want to spread them apart. And we want to wrap 2 of the 4 bands around that same peg that we did with the nostril, like so. Okay, like that. All right. Now, in my trial, I actually had the eyes bug out a little bit, but it didn't really look that good. So hopefully this will be better. Okay. All right, let's do his gigantic horn things, okay? So I'm using my neon orange for this, for the tip of the horn, okay? I'm going to wrap it around, creating 5 loops. Then I'm going to take a double looped neon orange and pull that cap band onto the double loop band and then reclaim it so it looks like a bow. Then we're going to take 5. Okay, we want these horns to look really thick, so we're going to take 5 neon orange, pull that onto the 5, reclaim. Alright, 5 more. Okay, then we're going to do burgundy, because it fades to burgundy, so I'm going to take 5 burgundy. 5 more burgundy. Five more. Something's funky there. Something went wrong. Okay. Five more. And one, two, so one more set of five. One, two, three, four, five. Okay. So you can put this on a holding hook, like I did here, and you want to make another one. So you have two, okay? So I'm going to put two. Once you have made both of them, they're both the same. We're going to get them both on the same hook. So make sure you go through all five loops. There we go. Okay, so they're both on the hook, and they're both bending the same direction. Okay, all right, I'm going to take two burgundies. Okay, and we're going to pull them both on. Okay, and we're going to wrap the burgundies around the same peg that the top of the eye is wrapped on. Okay, then what we want to do is we want to, like we did with the eyes and the nostrils, we're grabbing two of the four bands in the center between them and bringing them over this peg so the horns will angle that way. Okay, so that was attached here, here, and there. Okay, so there's nothing wrapped around this one from the horn thing we just did, just nothing that we just did. Okay, all right, so now we're gonna do the little horns that are behind the big horns. Okay, so I've already made one, so I'll make one with you, and then you can make the second one on your own. Okay, so again, we're wrapping a neon orange around our hook, creating five loops. We'll double loop a neon orange, attach that, and then we're going to do three neon orange. Pull that on, reclaim, then we'll do three burgundy. Pull that on and reclaim, and three more. Okay, so make your second one, and then we're gonna get them on the same hook. Okay. And then we're gonna take two burgundy bands, pull them on, and wrap them around the next set above the big horn. So this one, this one, and then spread them apart, grab two of the four bands between them, and bring that right up there. Okay, so they're just one set above the big horns. Okay, so we made a triangle with the big ones, we made a triangle with the small ones. Okay, all right, let's see here. Okay. So we're going to start to loop now. As we go up the center, we're going to attach some spikes, okay? So we're going to dig down past this spiky nose tip we did, okay? That will pretend that that's like a cap band, all right? So that's a cap band, so you got to dig down to find these diagonals, okay? So I'm going to dig down and find those. Sometimes it helps to turn your loom to the side, so you can see what you're grabbing there. Okay, make sure all the loops of that tip stay around there. All right, there's that. There's this side. Okay, now I can safely loop up the two sides. So let's do that first. We'll loop up this side. So dig all the way down to the bottom two bands. You go to the middle, all the way down the center of the peg to grab the bottom set, and you loop just the bottom set up. Oh, but before we get here, sorry, before we loop this guy, let's pause and put on some horizontals. So we're just going to put two burgundy across there, and then two more across up here. Okay, sorry about that. There we go. All right, continuing. Okay, here we've got to dig under the jaw to grab the two at the bottom. Let's do this side. only grabbing the two bands at the bottom of each set. Here, dig under the jaw. Okay. Alright, as we go up the middle, we're going to be attaching some spikes. So first we're going to do a nose spike. So take a yellow, we're going to creating five loops on your hook. Then we're going to double loop. I'm sorry, not a yellow, this is a neon orange like we were doing with the other horns. Okay. Alright, attach that, and then we're going to take three neon orange. Pull those on, and then we're going to take five burgundy. Bottom's going to be really thick. Pull that on. Okay. So it looks like that. Alright, so now we dig all the way down to grab the bottom two loops. As we loop that up, we're going to pull that onto them. Make sure you go through all the loops of that spike so you only have the two on your hook that you're supposed to have. Wrap that there. Okay. We're going to attach a smaller spike now. Okay. So watch what I'm doing because we're going to be making a few more of these throughout the video. Okay. So we're taking a neon orange, creating five loops on our hook. Then we want to double loop a band and pull that on there, reclaim it. And then we're going to take three burgundy and pull those on. Like so. Okay. Now as we loop up this next guy, remember we gotta dig down and just get the bottom two. As we loop that up, we're gonna pull that on. Okay, loop the next one up normally. Okay, the next one we're gonna do another spike just like this one. Okay, so I have one already made, so you can make one, and then as we loop up, we'll pull it on. Okay, next one gets looped up as normal, and then this next one, we're gonna make one more. Alright, dig down all the way under the jaw to grab the two burgundies at the bottom and pull that on. Okay, alright, take three random bands of any color. Doesn't matter because we're going to take them off later. Tie slip knots at the ends here, just like we did in the jaw before. Hopefully, I didn't forget anything. Guess we'll find out. Alright, from the bottom, we're going to gently lift him off. Might look a little weird at first. We gotta kind of adjust him with our fingers in a moment. So what we gotta do is we gotta push up from the bottom. Roar. Oh cool. He looks pretty cute. Not bad. Not bad, Courtney. Alright, so make sure everything's pushed up. Your teeth might be kind of hidden, but what you can do is you can take your hook and kind of tug them down on there, like so. You could just go into the tooth and just pull it down on the hook, or you could use your fingers, sometimes that's easier. Just do that. So I'm just gonna tug the teeth down so they're not hiding behind the bands of the tooth in front of it. I'll be able to see those teeth because they're pretty big. They're supposed to be pretty big. Ooh, these guys are really hidden. This one, I gotta take my hook, pull those out. All Alright. Haha, so there's his head. Okay. Looks kind of like a bunny rabbit, but I think that's the way he looks anyway. Alright. We're gonna make his, let's do his wing next. Okay. So I have made one wing so far. I'm gonna make one with you, and then I'm gonna have you go back and make the second one on your own. When you make the second one, you're gonna have to flip the video so you make it facing the other direction. Symmetry. Okay? The first one we'll do together here. Alright, so we're gonna take two burgundy bands at a time. Okay, hold on, something's funky here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, I see what I did. Okay, we're good. Alright. We're gonna take two bands at a time for our horizontals. Double loop one across these two guys. Okay, and we also want to double loop across those two, across these two, and across these two. Alright, okay, let's work on the little ridges. So, I'm going to take a burgundy and wrap around my hook, creating five loops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright, I'm going to double loop four times. So here's one, here's two, here's three, and here is four. Okay, now I'm going to take three burgundy and pull those off. Okay, this end we're going to put at the very end here, so we're going to wrap those bands around that peg there. Okay, Alright, we're going to make three more smaller ridges. So, double loop. I'm sorry, not double loop. Wrap a cap band on, creating five loops. Then, double loop, pull that on. And then take two bands, pull those on. Okay, and we're going to wrap that around this peg here at the end and turn it so the pointy end is facing out. Alright, we're going to make two more of those. Exactly the same as we just did. Here's one. We're going to go three pegs up, same side. And the final one goes right here. Okay. All right. So now we're going to start to loop these. Okay, so we want to pull this guy out so we can find the two diagonals. Okay, loop up that diagonal and then this guy. Stop there. Loop up once here. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to take a neon orange. Make sure it's not stretched out, okay? What we're going to do is we're going to gently wrap it twice around this peg. I wouldn't double loop it in your fingers because then it'll get stretched out. Take your hook and stretch it over that band. Okay, loop up once more on those same two columns. Do another one. Okay, so again, wrapped around twice, gently pulled across with the hook. Do it again. Okay, then we're gonna loop up twice. One, two. Same thing here. One, two. Okay. Alright, so now we're gonna do the same thing. So here's one. Loop up once. Another one. And last one. Okay, now we're gonna grab this guy and we're gonna go over to there. So we just looped horizontally all the way down and loop up. Okay? And then we're gonna go all the way up this Take two tying bands, any color, doesn't matter. Tie off your two ends. And gently pull them off. Sometimes I do pull it off from the top, but you want to be careful when you do that. Okay, so here is one wing, so you want to go back and create the second one opposite, okay? So you're going to do the same thing, but you're going to have it be opposite, so the wing ridges will come out from this side, okay? And your mango or neon orange bands will be on this side. If you don't know how to do that, just hold your screen up in front of a mirror. You'll see what I mean. Okay, so there are his, there's his head and his wings. So now let's do his back feet. Okay, you're going to make two of these, and you can actually make them exactly the same. You do not need to mirror anything here. Okay, so we're going to go down. One, two, three, four. Let's see. One, two, three, four. One, okay, two at a time. One, two, three, four. Okay, here we're gonna go down five times. And here we're gonna go down six times. So one, two, three, okay, take two bands across there, two bands across there, two across there, two across there, and then we'll double loop one across there, right? Now we're going to take three, we're going to put them there, take three more, put them there, take three more and put them there. Okay. All right. Take a burgundy and we're going to wrap it around our hook, creating five loops. And then we're going to add a double looped band. And we're going to add one more double looped band. Okay, this will get wrapped right around this peg here. We're going to make one more of those. So exactly the same, that gets wrapped around this peg here. Right. Okay, now we're going to make his foot. Okay, so take your burgundy, wrap it around creating five loops, then double loop a burgundy, add that, do another burgundy, and do one more. Okay, push that down on your hook, create another one that's exactly the same. Okay, now we're going to take three yellows. I'm going to pull those two toes onto the three yellows. Okay, push that down on your hook. Then take the other end. Sorry, I just wanted to clean off that camera. It looked dirty. Okay, put your finger through the other end. Then take three yellows. Wrap around your hook, creating three loops with the three yellows all at once. So it's like a big hunk of bands. Reclaim the loops that were around your finger. Take three yellow bands on your hook and pull all those onto those three yellow bands. Reclaim the loop on the other side. And we're gonna wrap this right around the bottom here. All six loops go around that bottom peg. And now we can loop the leg. Make sure you do it in the same order that I'm doing it. Okay. All right, tie off these three ends with any color, doesn't matter, because we'll be taking them off later. Slip knots at the three ends. All Alright, let's pull this off and see how it looks. Roar. Cool. Alright, so there is one back foot. Okay. You want to make another one. Okay, so you have two. Okay, you can make it exactly the same. Doesn't matter. Okay. Great. Alright, let's do his claws. So his front scorpion-like things. What is he, like a scorpion dragon? Alright, we're gonna take three yellows. Then we're gonna do three double loops. So here's one double looped. Here's two double looped. Here's three double looped. Okay, then we're gonna do three yellow. Okay, then three yellow again. Okay, now we're gonna do two yellow in the middle, two yellow there, and two yellow here. Okay. Now we want to go to burgundy. So two burgundy there, two burgundy there, and two burgundy there. Two across here. Two across there. And what we're going to do is we're going to cap off right in the middle. So doing one band, wrapping around, creating four loops. Okay. For horizontals, we're going to double loop. So I'm going to double loop my yellow. Cross. And we're also going to do a yellow one here as well. Okay. All right, we're going to make the little pincers. Okay. Now this is the one arm I have already made. The pincers are kind of big on mine. You can make yours a little smaller if you want to, and I will tell you how. Okay, to make them like mine, what we're going to do is we're going to wrap around creating five loops. Then we'll double loop one, pull it on, then we're going to take three bands and pull that on. Okay, so if you want to make your pincers smaller, you're going to stop there and you're going to attach this right to here. But I want to make mine the same because I already did the other side. So, here we go. Okay, that gets wrapped around here. And I'm going to do the other one exactly the same way. Okay, this one goes around here. Okay. Alright, go under the cap band. Grab the top two and loop them across right over that pincer. Same thing here. Okay, we're going to go up this column first. So all the way down to the bottom, grab only the bottom two, those two. Alright, loop up. And then we're also going to do a diagonal there. Now, before we do this side, what we're going to do is we are going to attach the two little ridges here, okay? So, grab a band, wrap around creating five loops. I almost forgot that. Double loop one. Pull it on. Double loop another one. Pull that on. Okay, this is going to go right around here. And we're going to turn it so it's pointing outward. We're going to make one more. All just like that. Okay. All right, so now we're going to loop up that column. All right, and now we're going to go right up the center. Now watch carefully. What we're going to do is we're going to loop up these three. Then what we're going to do is we're going to take a burgundy onto our hook, wrap it around, creating three loops. We're going to lift up all six of those loops we just looped and pull that on. Okay? Make a little stripe there. Place those back over. Of course, I missed one. And loop all the way up to the top. And we're going to also attach one to the top set as well. Okay, so one burgundy band, wrap around, creating three loops. Lift off all six loops. Pull that on. Replace the six loops. And tie off your end with a random color. All right, we're going to carefully lift this off now. All right, so there is one of his claws. Roar. So, you want to make two of those arms, okay? And what we can do is we can stick our hook through a set where the elbow would be and just tug. Oops, no, that's the wrong way. These little pointy things are at the bottom, so we want to go that way and tug. His arm's going to be all skewed. Wait, what am I doing? I don't know. Okay, so it's like that. Alright, so you want to make two arms. Oh, mine are both bent the same way. And mine are all both bent the same way, which is what we can do is we can always bend one to face the other way, but it's going to take some time. So what you would want to do is stick your hook through and just tug everything the opposite way. Stick your hook through and tug. Yeah, there we go. Same thing with the little pincers. You can always tug them to go a certain direction as well. Roar! This guy is the weirdest looking dragon I've ever seen in my life. I'm like, ooh, there's no way I'm doing that dragon on Rainbow Loom, but I had so many requests for him that here he is. Okay. So now we have two arms for him. Okay. Roar. Alright, so next we're going to do his tummy. Alright, so we're going to take our yellow. Okay, we're going to go down 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're going to go down 10 times. With two bands at a time. Gonna go diagonally. And we're gonna go straight like that. And then we're gonna go this way. two, both going toward the center like that. So two there, two there. All right, we're going to do our horizontals. Now the top three horizontals, we're going to double loop the yellow. So we're going to double loop there, double loop here, and we're going to double loop here. Okay. Well, let's double loop the next one too. Now we're going to take two bands there, two there, two there, and two here. And we're going to take one and do a cap band right here. One, two, three, wrap around four loops. All right, here's our stomach. Let's loop this guy. Okay, what I'm going to do here, I'm going to take, let me think here. I am going to take. Take two of the burgundy. Okay, two burgundy bands. You know what? No, I'm not gonna take two burgundy bands. I'm gonna double loop a yellow. Double loop a yellow and bring that through all those loops. This is gonna make it easier to attach later. Instead of looping around 12 loops, we'll only have to loop around 4. Okay, and now I'm going to tie it off with a burgundy. Oops. Okay, so tie a slip knot around that double looped yellow. Okay. Alright, let's take this off. Roar. Haha. Ooh, he's going to be cute. Little body, but he'll be cute. It's alright, he's a baby. Okay. Alright, now we're going to make the main body and attach everything to it. Actually, before that, let's work on the tail a little bit. So he's got three, like, tail stinger thingamajiggies. They're all different colors, okay? So I'm going to make the first one with you here. Alright, so the tips are the neon orange color. So we're going to take, move that aside for now, just for a little bit. Take a neon orange and wrap around, creating 5 loops. Then we'll double loop a neon orange. And we're going to double loop another neon orange. Okay, now we're going to take 5 burgundy. Okay, 5 burgundy again. Alright, now I'm gonna take a double looped burgundy. Take another double looped burgundy. And one more. Okay, so we got 3 double looped small ones after that big one. There's his little stinger. Okay, we're gonna do the lightest color stinger first. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a double looped yellow, pull it on, another double looped yellow, pull pull it on, and then a double looped burgundy. Pull that on, and we're going to create a pattern, so we're going to do that again. Okay, so double looped yellow. Double looped yellow. Double looped burgundy. Okay, and we're going to keep going. So just stay with me here. Double looped. Double looped yellow. Double looped yellow. Double looped burgundy. Double looped yellow. Double looped yellow. Double looped burgundy. Double looped yellow. Double looped yellow. Double looped burgundy. Okay, double looped yellow. Double looped yellow. Double looped. You guessed it. Burgundy. Wait, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21. Okay. Again. Double looped yellow. Double looped yellow. Double looped. Burgundy. Double looped yellow. Double looped yellow. Double looped burgundy. So right now we have the three browns, so 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so after that, you're going to take 3 burgundy. Okay, and then you can put that on a holding hook. Okay, so that's one of his little tail stingers. You're going to make another one that's the same thing, but it's going to be all burgundy with just that neon orange tip like we had here. Okay, so make two, or I'm sorry, make that one too, so you have two so far. And then the final one we're going to make at the very end. Okay. So don't make the third one yet. Okay. Right, time for the body here. Right, the body's gonna be burgundy, and I'm gonna see if I can put some of these neon orange stripes onto here. We'll see how that works out. Ha ha. Okay, so we're gonna start here. So, burgundy. Actually, you know what I'm gonna do? This is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do... I think here. Three burgundy here. Okay. Yeah, okay. Double loop of burgundy up here. Then we're going to put 3 burgundy here. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. Okay. All right, now 2 burgundy there. So double looped, 1 double looped, then 3 regular, then 2 regular. Okay. Go that way. And that way. Okay. Alright. I'm gonna double loop a neon orange across the back here. Across his back. Okay. Whew. Okay. We're gonna do burgundy. Burgundy. Burgundy, then we're going to do the same thing. So double loop the neon orange. Okay. Let's do it again. So burgundy, 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 thing. Double loop the neon orange here. Okay. Do it again. Burgundy. 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 Double loop. A neon orange across. Okay. Now I'm gonna do burgundy there, burgundy here, and I'm gonna attach a big spike to the one that I do here, okay? So let's make a big spike. So neon orange wrapped around creating five loops. Then we wanna double loop one. Okay, then we're gonna take three neon orange. Then we're gonna do, let's do five neon orange. We'll make this nice one nice and big. One, two, three, four, five neon orange. And then five burgundy. Four, five. Roar. Okay. Take two burgundy, pull that on. And we're gonna wrap those two ends here and here. Okay, and then what we wanna do is we wanna just push that spike down. Okay, so it's like not in our way. All right. Then we're going to double loop a neon orange across again. Actually, you know what we can do? Let's skip one here. Skip one. Okay, we'll create a little gap in the spikes like we did in the wings. It'll be pretty kind of cool, I think. Okay, so one, two, three, four, five. Okay. So what we're gonna do here. Let me just check something here. Yeah, okay, we're gonna do one more set. Okay, so. Okay, wait, first we gotta do a double loop neon orange. Okay, then we're gonna go here, and then we're gonna do another spike here. And it's gonna be a little bigger than this one. It was really hard to find a diagram of the triple strike, so I kind of just had to go by photos from the show, and there really weren't that many. So I don't have Netflix anymore, so I can't really look and pause on Netflix. So my apologies. So double looped onto that cap band, then we'll take three yellow, then we'll do five. Okay, then we'll do... Let's do five again. One, two, three, four, five. And then we'll do five burgundy. Actually, you know what? Let's. Yeah, that's fine. You could do it that way. I'm just going to make the burgundy a little more. So I'm going to do. Take one of the mango sets or neon orange sets off and do two burgundy sets instead. Just because it looks like the neon orange is more at the tip and not so much at the bottom, I think. But like I said, I don't know. I'm just taking a guess here. Alright, I guess we'll see how that looks. It looks really big, but let's do it. Okay, that goes here. Alright, again, we're going to push that down so it's underneath. Not in our way. Okay, now I'm going to take one of my wings here. Okay, so let's take our wings. What we're going to do is we're going to hold them like this and then flip them like that. Okay, so let's start on this side. I'm going to take this one. Remember, the stripes are facing down. We're going to go through the loops here at the bottom and wrap them here. Okay, we're going to do the same over here. Oh, wait, before we do that, sorry, take that off. Let's do our stripe first. Neon orange stripe across. Okay, now let's do that. Okay. Again, make sure the stripes are facing down. Okay. Alright, let's do... So I only touched the bottom set on each wing so far. Two bands there. Two bands here. Two bands here. Okay, now we're going to attach the top set to that peg. So this top set around the loops goes there. And this top set around the loops goes here. Okay. Oh, I gotta do the stripes first. Do it again. Just pull those sets off. Let's do our stripe. Stripe across, double looped. Remember, all these stripes are double looped, because if you don't double loop them, then they're gonna lift, like, they're not gonna be flat against the body. They're gonna be more like lifting off the body, and it's gonna look not like stripes, it's just gonna look weird. Okay, let's do here. Oh, you know what? Let's put those there. Let's put those there. Two there. Put two here. And then what we're gonna do is we're going to we're gonna do a spike on this one. Okay, I'm gonna make it the same size as the first one we did here. A little bit smaller. Just a guess on how these spikes look. I really couldn't find what they looked like in a picture. Okay, so double loop a yellow. Then take three yellows. Or not yellows, neon orange. And I think this one's five, yeah, okay. And take five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we're gonna do 5 burgundy, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, grab 2 burgundy and we'll pull those on. So, push that down, okay, and then we're going to do another stripe, our last stripe here, okay, and then we'll do 2 burgundy there, 2 burgundy here, and 2 burgundy here. Okay. Alright, what we're going to do now is we're going to attach the legs and the arms, okay? So, take your legs. We're going to attach them like this. Okay, so the three ends here are going to go on these three pegs, and these three ends are going to go on these three pegs. Okay, so make sure the foot is facing the wing. The wings that we put on. Okay, so here's one set. Here's two sets. Here's three. Oh, wait.
I gotta move this up a set.
Yeah, sorry. Move these legs up one set. Yeah. Sorry, these go here. 1, 2, 3, okay. Because we have to attach the tails here. Okay, we'll do that very soon. 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's do the other one. So, going to do. Our front legs. Okay, so this one is gonna go here. Okay, so we want them to be bending up like that. All right, so this one, we're putting it in the peg right before the wing. So right, we're gonna go through the six loops, or however many there are. That one goes there. And this one will go here. Okay. Like that. All right. I'm going to put some horizontals on with the burgundy, which I actually forgot. I'm going to put two across here where there isn't any horizontals. Okay, across there. We're going to put two across here. And we'll double loop one across here. Actually, I guess we don't really need that, do we? We'll just put them across where there aren't any in that one set. Let's hope it'll be alright. Yeah, it'll be fine. Okay, let's attach the tail pieces that we've done so far. Okay, so the brown tail. Now my computer gives you the opposite. So see how my wedding ring is on my right hand to you? It's actually on my left, but to you it looks like it's on my right because my computer mirrors everything. So you're going to attach your brown tail to here. Okay, because it's actually on that. Oh wait, no, I'm sorry. No. You're going to attach your brown tail to here. To there. Yes, attach it there. I'm going to put it here because my mirror's it. The brown tail is on that side. And I'm going to attach it so it is bending down. So it's bent down so that when we take it off, it'll bend upward. And then your yellow stripy tail will go here. Same thing, so it's bending downward. Okay, we're gonna make the final one at the end once we loop up to here, then we'll continue and make the final one. All right, let's do the head. Okay, so the head, we're gonna turn it upside down. Make sure it's upside down. And we're gonna attach our three ends to these three pegs. So make sure you go through the burgundy loops here. Wrap them around here. Sometimes I take the tying bands off and sometimes I leave them on. Okay, we can take all these tying bands off at the end. Alright, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my stomach, okay? Hold it so it's curling down, but then we're going to flip it this way. Okay, so now it's curling up. The end is curling up. Go through the cap band here. What we're going to do is we're going to wrap that cap band around this middle bottom peg. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to loop all the way up to here. Okay. Right up the middle. So I'm going to dig all the way down. Find those two. Oops, it's super tricky sometimes. Ugh, of course my screen froze. Hold on, guys. My screen times out. I'm gonna have to re-enter the password. Pain in the butt. Still going? Yes, okay. Alright, anyway, I'm digging down to find those. Oops. This is probably the trickiest thing so far. So we want to grab the right ones. Okay, perfect. Alright. I'm going to continue going up this column. Skip past the Mang or neon orange horizontals. Okay. All right, we're stopping there. We can't loop that one till these have been looped, and we can't loop those till we do this part. All right, now, while this is still upside down, or the stomach is still hanging like this, we're gonna find the two sets next to the cap band. So this set, we're gonna go through the four loops, okay? So open up that set, wrap it around that peg. Then we're gonna loop up one time. Okay, we're gonna do that on the other side as well. Okay, so go through the four loops here, wrap them around this peg. Dig down. And loop up. Okay, now what we can do with the stomach is gently lift it onto those pegs that we just looped, so now it's like up like that. Alright, we're going to open up the four loops on the next set. I'm not going through the horizontal band, there's a horizontal band in here, but I'm going below it, opening up the four loops, and wrapping those around the next peg. Dig all the way down past the neon orange to the two burgundy at the very bottom, loop up. Same thing on this side. So we're going to open up the four loops, wrap it around that arm set. Go all the way to the bottom, loop up. If your bands tend to snap a lot during this, it's probably because you're not using genuine rainbow loom bands, or your hook is messed up, or you might have a fake rainbow loom. There are a lot of counterfeit looms and bands out there. So if yours keeps breaking, that might be why. Okay, so we're just going to continue doing that. So we go set by set, loop. Okay, so wrap and loop, one set at a time. And don't skip any, because then it's not going to fit right. We're only going through the sets on the edge of that stomach. Now, as it starts to get really stretched out, we can slowly lift him off. I'm just going to lift off about three sets. So there's one, or three rows rather, two, and three. All right, next one. Wrap around. Next one here, wrap around. Okay, let's do the next one. And you'll start to see him come off the loom. There's always a little bit of fun. All right, I'm gonna lift off two more sets. Got some stripes on his back. One, two. Off a little bit, because if you lift it all the way off, he's just gonna come apart. Oh, he's pretty cute. Just keep looming. Just keep looming. he looks like a triple strike. Well, he's supposed to, anyway. So that's good. Okay, here, we're gonna first do this side. Then we're gonna do this side. And then we're gonna do the middle. Don't forget this middle set. Otherwise he'll fall apart and you'll be really sad. Alright, I'm gonna go up one more here. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go through this double looped band at the end, stretch that all the way up to there, and wrap that around there. Okay, then we're gonna do this set. Okay. Take your hook through that end and pull it off. Make sure it stays on your hook. Nerve-wracking. This is like the scariest part. Oh, look how cool he is, guys. Roar. We're not done yet, though. We've still got a little more to do here. Okay. So now we have to create the middle tail, okay? That one is the neon orange color. Okay, so after I do that, after I pull it off, I'm gonna do a double looped neon orange and add that. Okay, add one. Take another one, add that, then we're gonna do the burgundy. Okay, then we're gonna do the neon orange. So essentially we're doing the same thing we did with the other part of the tail, creating the pattern. It's just the opposite direction. Interesting, right? Okay, then the burgundy. Okay, so going, so neon orange, neon orange, burgundy, neon orange, neon orange. And burgundy. Neon orange. Neon orange. Burgundy. Keep going. Neon orange. Orange, burgundy, neon orange. We actually don't need our lumen anymore, so you can put that aside. Neon orange, burgundy. Alright, how many more sets do we need? Orange, neon orange, and burgundy. Okay, and then we're gonna do, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so now we're gonna do two more burgundies. So two more double loop burgundy. One and two, and then we take five burgundy. Five burgundy again. And then we're going to do a double looped neon orange. We're actually going to do 3 double Lubni on orange. I know the other ones have 2. We're going to do 3 on this one, because when we tuck in the end, it's going to shorten it a little bit. So 3 neon orange. And then we're going to take one more neon orange and do a slip knot. And we're just going to tuck that slip knot in by going through the second double looped set, pulling that loose end through, and then just zigzagging it around in that little tip there, back and forth, as best you can, till it kind of just disappears in there, and you don't see it anymore. Just kind of tug it in there. Okay. Yeah, so now we can take out all these tying bands, and then I'm going to show you how to adjust things on here, okay? So, if you wrapped everything correctly, it should not fall apart when you take the tying bands off. It's always very nerve-wracking when you're doing this part. Oh yeah, see, that loop didn't wrap around on that leg. But the other one did, so I'm alright. If any one of them kind of falls apart, you can always just tie it up and just hide the band in there instead of redoing the whole thing, because that's just frustrating to redo everything. Okay. Tying band here. See, I missed that one too. So that's 2 loops I missed. I used a different color than what I used in my project for these tying bands, because some of them are kind of hard to find. Alright, I think I got them all. Oh, except for this one here. Oh, okay, yeah, so this one here we can also take off. Here we go. Okay. So, if your spikes are facing the wrong way, like on his back, they're kind of pointed toward his head, all you gotta do is just take your hook, stick them through those spikes, and tug them the correct direction. Okay, so I'm gonna do that. Okay, the bottom drum, I'm just going to kind of pull out a little bit because it's a little short. Okay. The spikes on the head should really be facing straight back. So what you can always like stick your hook and tug them if they're curving down or up. You could tug them the other way just to kind of straighten them out like that. Okay, things look all right. Front legs, if you want them to angle down, just stick your hook through the first set, the top, and tug downward. Same thing over here. Okay, and then the back legs, they're kind of sprawled to the side, right? So if you want them to face down, just take your hook, go through the top set of bands on the leg and just tug downward, and then they will be facing down. On this side I actually missed a band, so oh well, I guess I could just tuck it in or something, I don't know. Just tuck it in somewhere. Okay, guys, that's pretty much it for this guy. You can always stick a wire through him. Okay. Or there's his three tails, and of course the three tails like to twist on each other, so you can always wrap them if you want. You braid them or whatever, they twist around like that, I think. Okay, pretty cool. He actually looks really good compared to what I was expecting. Alright guys, I hope you like him, and show me pictures of him on Facebook and Instagram. See the links in the description, and be sure to follow me on Instagram if you have one, and Facebook, and definitely show me pictures of the ones you make. I'd especially love to see like different colors, and different color combinations are really cool. Alright, so I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. And we are done. I hope you can see him really good if you're just looking at what he looks like. He's pretty cool. He's got a lot of parts to him. Okay, there's his head, his horns, there's his little claw arms on each side, his back legs, his wings. Okay, there he is. Well, guys, I will see you next time for another tutorial. Okay. Have a wonderful, wonderful day. Enjoy your triple strike.